What do we have left but to tell our stories? As Christians, of course, we are part of some other stories. We are part of the story of the church, and we're part of the story of God's work in the world. Because we're Christians, we know that Christ came not just to reconcile human beings, but to reconcile all of the earth. Fellowship with Christ, our brother, and grace anew every morning as it flows into our souls and body. This is the triune God. A field of love making us alive together and giving us hope for ourselves, for the church, and for the world. This is our common story. And I challenge you to write the next chapter for the church and the world. Thank you.
My first memory of Melissa is when she became known to me before we ever moved the FTE to Atlanta. And I kept hearing about this bright Woodruff scholar at Candler. And the only thing that I heard negative about her was that she was a lawyer from Texas.
Another memory that I had was when Jim Waits announced that he was going to go on sabbatical. And you remember we were in the same room and we chatted and laughed and said, I can't believe this. We've been here the sum total of maybe 2 weeks, and we have to put together a program and read a narrative for a grant and try to figure it out and put it all together, and we don't even have pens and paper.
And so I must have been there within maybe a week, and Melissa comes and shares some news with me. She says, here are my two folders on the program, and I want to let you know that I'm going to be gone for the next month on sabbatical. And I was like, what? For the next month? And she's like, yeah, I'll be fine. But you'll be fine. You got everything right here in this folder. You'll figure it out.
Melissa and I have been work colleagues for a long time, but we have also been the best of friends. And I think that one of the ways that our friendship was cemented is the fact that we traveled together so often. We did site visits together, we went to meetings together, to events and to conferences.
A trip among many that we took to Lilly Endowment. And of course the event was 9/11. And then living out those next 2 days in a car with two other colleagues that we drove from Indianapolis with down to Nashville. We dropped off two colleagues there, and the eeriness of going into the Nashville airport with nothing, no sound. It was so odd. And then I remember, I said, girlfriend said, I'm car sick. I can't drive, Sharon. So I said, oh Lord, now we have come all the way down here. We spent the night. And then she says, I'm car sick. And I said, okay, Melissa, here we go. So I drove from Nashville all the way down to Atlanta.
One of the great things about Melissa as a traveling companion is that she is what I have dubbed a lint roller, which means that wherever we went, whether we were in an airport or on a busy sidewalk in New York City, people that we didn't know would come up to Melissa and ask her questions, ask her for directions, tell her stories about themselves that had not been solicited. And so one of the great joys of being with her and all of that time was seeing her interact with people, which of course is one of her great gifts.
One of the great things that I think she, traits that she has, is that of a kind of immediate engagement of students. And so for that reason, she was a wonderful partner in this ministry to the students and a great model for them.
So first thing I wanted to say to you is that as you can see from the sign here, I'm now Reverend David Lewicki. When you first met me, I was not that place, but I am now. I'm the pastor, co-pastor of North Decatur Presbyterian Church, and I need to let you know that I hold you accountable for this. Melissa, somehow you end up still being excited about this church and about the fact that young people are still called by God to serve it, and that this is actually a good thing to do with a person's life. And you communicate that so well in your spirit and in your person. So being near you, hearing you speak, hearing your words of encouragement, it makes people like me excited about this work.
She really is someone who challenges us to think critically and deeply about our convictions and not just take them for granted or speak about them without really understanding deeply why we believe what we believe. And so I really appreciated the way that she has helped me to actually grow into my own theological understanding as of myself as a Quaker more deeply than even perhaps others in my own tradition have been able to do.
Melissa, you're off to Texas again, and I can only wish you the very best in this new ministry that you're undertaking. You will go with the confidence of so many of us that will be the kind of exemplary vocation that we've come to love and respect in you.
This is what I want to say to you, Melissa. It's been a great 7 years working with you, and we've had some really great times, and I've really appreciated getting to work with you, to learn more about your interests and ideas and your love for the church, and also trusting in me for the shared work that we have worked on here at the Fund for Theological Education. I want to tell you that I wish you the very best, and I thank you for putting your trust in me. And now I'm going to trust that God will bless you in all that you do as you move on to your new role as Vice President for Education Beyond the Walls at Austin Seminary.
So here are the pews where all the congregation comes, and all of their stories and their journeys and their hopes and their fears are now part of mine. And I have you to blame for all of this. But I just also wanted to say that I have you to thank because I love what I do right now. And the encouragement and the support that you and everyone at FTE, but particularly you, have given me over the years has made this possible. So I wanted you to see me in this place, and I wanted you to hear me along with all the other voices say, Melissa, thank you. God bless you, and I wish you all the best in your new ministry at Austin Seminary.
It is exactly what you were created to do, which is to make something up right out of your brain and your heart. I think that all these qualities that people are lifting up about you will serve you well. The fact that you are such a hard worker, that you are so creative, and that you are so in love with the people that God has created on this earth. So many, many blessings, and I look forward to more travel in the future.
Well, so long, Melissa. I hope that our paths will meet. In fact, I'm sure they will meet as we both move forward. And you know I like Howard Thurman, and I just want to quote him again as my final word to you. Fly in the greatness of God, even as the marsh hen flies, filling all the space twixt the marsh and the skies. God is not finished with you. God is not finished with creation. Fly in the greatness of God, even as the marsh hen flies. So long, friend. Be encouraged.